So hello, everyone. Thank you for allowing us to come and follow up on our son's speech that he gave for graduation. You know, Randy and I both comment every time we read the speech, we find new things that resonate so much and are so amazing that a 17-year-old kid wrote that speech. We didn't write that speech. In fact, Oliver didn't even share that speech in its entirety with us before he gave it. What I think is so important to recognize is that a 15, 16, and 17-year-old boy experienced all of this. This isn't an adult managing stress. It's a child managing stress. It's interesting, I have a notebook back there of notes. I take notes at all the PAC meetings. And in 2015, our first year here, I'm writing in the margins, why is this school so stressful? Like, I felt it when I arrived, whether it was in the more than anything in the high school environment, but I felt it in middle school. I felt this current happening in this town that is so lovely and the people so good individually, yet as a whole, Randy and I both experienced Oliver's first words when he came in after his first day of school was, oh my word, everybody's on their phones checking their grades every second of the day. That was a new phenomenon to us. And yet, it doesn't take long to see how things happen and how everyone dives in, and that's how it is. So when Randy and I were talking about environment and what we want to sort of talk about three things today, which is our observations as parents, but also recognizing that Oliver's not alone. The minute Oliver finished his speech, for those who were able to hear it at the graduation, my phone was buzzing with, he nailed it. That hit my child's experience right on. That's exactly what we've been feeling at home. Oh my gosh, has he been in our kitchen every night? Like, and yet no one really talks about it. So we were really proud of Oliver that he was adamant. In fact, in the beginning, against my wishes, when he first told me his idea about his speech, I looked at him and said, Ollie, grandparents are coming from across the country. Parties are being thrown. This is Yahoo. We did it. We are living. We made it. And he would have none of it. He was adamant about sharing this experience because, as he said in that speech, he watched these young men, these young boys manage through the stress and the sadness and the depression. In fact, when I posted this, his speech on my Facebook page, realizing no one heard it or few heard it, I mean, I don't know, 200 comments, private emails, but a local therapist reached out to me to ask me if she could print off Oliver's speech and share it with her many Long Meadow clients, patients, and parents, because so many think they're alone. And it's in discussion with parents, our students, these families, are all doing their best with the skills that they have to manage through the stresses, be it academic, be it social, be it athletic, because those issues are pervasive in all three of those areas. But what's so interesting is, in spite of the stress, in spite of the rigor, which if you look up rigor, the demanding, exhaustive, and these are all words that Ollie used in his speech, unapologetic rigor is a term thrown around with pride in Long Meadow. It's scary, and the effects are detrimental. And when I talk to people and I see, in spite of all of that, there is academic success, that's athletic success, and we all pride ourselves on that, yet no one peels back the layers or opens up the curtain and sees the tutors necessary to help a child achieve the grade. No one looks at the therapists, the psychologists necessary to partner with families and children to get through the toxic environment that's created by, like Ollie said, all of those areas, be it school, be it at home, be it community. And so I'm going to let my husband speak in a minute. But what was really important to me is as I sat through PAC meetings and I see the effects of the community of parents doing their best to manage through it all, is that it is systemic. And it isn't just happening in Longmeadow. People reached out to me from across the country. Yet, this is our community. And we have to do differently if we want different results. And Ollie's speech was so courageous to me, because in spite of this people looking sideways at him or expecting a different speech, he said what had to be said. And so we wanted him to come and speak to you, because I wanted you to hear it from the mouth of a 17-year-old boy. He's a boy. These are young boys and girls in this town that are being subjected to the community, and lovely, wonderful things from this community as well. That's why it's so maddening, so much goodness, and so much sadness. So I'm going to pass it over to Randy.
Great. Thank you.
You bet.
Hi, folks. I'm Randy Davis. There's not a whole lot that I can necessarily add. I think Oliver nailed a lot of it. But I can share with everyone that we do have a unique perspective. We are not Longmeadow natives. We didn't grow up in Longmeadow. We're not acculturated to Longmeadow. We come from Kansas, for whatever that means, is the last place. We've been in California. We're both public school graduates in college and undergraduate, and that's or college and everything else. What I can tell you is that wherever we move to the best school district. That's always what we do, because that's our priority, is for our kids. And it, without question, in Western Massachusetts, the reputation is Longmeadow is the place. And it was a very easy, we didn't even really look anywhere else. It was, we're going to come to Longmeadow. So without question, Longmeadow has great results and a great reputation. We were troubled with the environment and the culture very early on. And what I will simply tell you is that we have been exposed to environments that do it differently, that have a different culture, where there is collaboration between parents and the school. And the first comments that we had was, there seems to be a war going on between the parents and the school. And this isn't good, and this isn't healthy. And so I think we sort of sat around different levels of engagement or concerns.
Sat around. And bonbons.
And I will tell you that Oliver's speech, just to give you context, I remember him sharing, we were actually driving to winter break and having this discussion, and in his mind, in February, he started writing this speech. That was when he started with this, despite many, many discussions that we had with him. He was a dog with a bone. He was not going to let it up. And he wouldn't, as Amy shared, he would not share it with us. He would not let us see it. We didn't, just so you know, we didn't have any involvement in it one way or another. And so I just want to close this without belaboring the point is, we have seen a different environment with highly successful outcomes, because that's what we want. Is successful outcomes. There are different ways to get it. I would just say that the most important line that Oliver put in his deal is, and I think I highlighted it so that I could go to it, is simply this. There are numerous possible solutions, but what's important today is recognizing that the issue exists. So my question to you as the school committee is, do you see this as an issue or not? Because if you don't see it as an issue, that's fine. And you guys can and move on in your way. If you do see it as an issue, then that's the start of now, what do we do about it? So that's my question to you guys. Is it a concern of yours? And on a scale of 1 to 10, what level of concern? And I don't know if you, I don't know that I get to ask that question, but I throw that out there for hyperbole or dramatics.
No, you absolutely can ask it. And when we get to our agenda item to discuss as a group, I wrote the question down and we will definitely address it and consider it. I would thank you both for coming, for taking the time. I applaud it. I think we don't see enough of it. I would say, without getting into the discussion of the actual speech, that we need more parent involvement and feedback. So I hope that not only what you've done tonight in terms of acting as a catalyst or shedding a light, that other parents will look at that as an example and say, because it's a brave thing to do. And I think Oliver hit on it in his speech. It's an uncomfortable, and I meant to say this before he left, the last part of his paragraph where he said, I understand this is most likely uncomfortable to hear, and I apologize. He shouldn't apologize.
Yeah.
Uncomfortable conversations are okay to have. So I appreciate, we're all partners, stakeholders in our system here, and that's why we serve on the committee. That's why we're here, to partner with administration, to partner with parents, to partner with teachers. But a big piece also is what I think sometimes we miss, and I think Oliver brought it to our attention, to partner with our own students.
Yes.
And ask them, how are things going for you? Mm-hmm. So thank you for not only coming with your remarks, but for bringing your son, because we're all pieces of this. And I think when we all work together, we can find solutions that grow our district and make it a place where, you know, we can still achieve amazing results. So thank you so much.
Awesome. Thank you,
and
guys.
And you're welcome to stay for the duration of our meeting because you are under new business as, but that's entirely up to you.
So I have one more thing to add to all of this. I think one of the most, I think we can all agree that we all want our kids to be healthy. We want them to be to learn in a healthy and a happy, a joyful environment, and want them to be safe. Those are my most important accountabilities as a parent, and I take them seriously. And based on what I've seen the last 3 years, and my hope to be involved in PAC and to shift mindset and to see change, that quite frankly, I haven't seen. And then, coupled with Oliver's speech and our daughter Louisa's, you know, Oliver was never a freshman. He came here as a sophomore. So there was part of me was like, to come in as a sophomore, that's tough, you know, but then he became the school or the class president. So he was acclimated really quickly. But Louisa was a freshman here, so I was interested in seeing what Louisa's life was like as a student. And Louisa mirrored his sentiments in his speech throughout the year, but at one really crucial time in the spring, and we brought it to the attention of her teachers, the stress she was feeling, and it was really clear that there's this bar and the student has to jump it, especially if they're in a high-level class. It's like, and if you can jump it, I'm going to raise it a little bit more, because it's honors. There's this element of wearing the level of the course on the sleeve. I see not across the board, but I see it there, and it's stressful. And words like dread that Oliver used in his speech, I just reread it, words like dread and stress, dread for this fabulously creative, clever girl is unacceptable. So I want you to know that I think it's unacceptable what's happening here. I think it's been unacceptable. I think the culture in the schools is synonymous with toxicity, with toxic. It's not 100%. There's no all or nothing. But boy, when you have good-natured, good kids feeling after they graduate, and this isn't just Oliver, and they use the word hate to their 4 years at Longmeadow High School, you've got a problem. And I started my last little sort of feeling with healthy, safe, happy, a culture that's nurturing, that creates a lifelong learner. That's my goal as a mother. And so we will not be sending Louisa to Longmeadow High School her sophomore year or her junior year. You don't get her senior year. I won't allow it. I do not want my daughter or my son after Louisa to write this speech. No way. And the bummer is we bought our house for the school district. And for an administrator to sit and not be alarmed and outraged that someone wrote this speech and doesn't sit down and talk about culture and climate and how did that happen, that's inexcusable. It's embarrassing to me. And it's shameful. and I love this community, and I want the best for this community. In fact, professionally, I'm all about health, happiness, and fulfillment and success in lives of families and kids. And I want it for Long Meadow, but I won't sacrifice one more of my sweet little people. Won't do it. So thank you for allowing us to speak. We intend to come back and speak again and provide specifics so you can start to, again, based upon our assessment, but I'm certain you'll have other parents coming and sharing theirs. I think we've opened up the window, and I think you're going to get some parental involvement in helping to shift and to change systemically the schools. I mean, if there's a will, there's a way. And I'm certainly committed to help you in that process. And thank you.
Thank you for sharing your thoughts.